let's check out the journal. I was waiting to see if she's gonna read. She faked me out last time. Okay. November 17th, 2017. Food rescue. 3 years. We had a party today, celebrating 3 years of food rescue. Everyone was there. All those happy, familiar faces. Loved it. Kelsey came in. I never took her for one of the hungry. I don't think she knows my name, but everyone knows hers. She's gorgeous. It surprised me, is all. I could see the shame in her eyes when she had to accept the bag of groceries from me. Still, I couldn't take my eyes off her. If this world allows someone like Kelsey to be hungry, it must be everywhere. So I'm going to fight it with everything I've got. November 21st. OMG! They put me on Kelsey's team. My heart races whenever I stop to think about it. Don't think she's all that pleased, though. I wonder whether she remembers me from food rescue. God. I hope not. I feel so connected to her. Isn't that weird? I'd love for us to be friends. She's just amazing. Can't wait to start working on our science project. Did you get that? Our project. I feel like I'm going to explode from excitement. Huh. December 4th. So, it's about like a week and a half or something later. Or 2 weeks later. Arg, 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 arg. I screwed up, but I was worried. I'm still worried. And what else could I do? Kelsey hasn't been to food rescue in a while, and I just wanted to make sure she wasn't hungry or something, so I offered her my sandwich. Arg, why did I do that? Now we'll never be friends. Good one, Marie. Really, really well done. She looked at me like I was crazy and walked out, and now we're behind with the project too. I hope we make the deadline. December 22nd. Just stop. Why do you keep writing this shit? I know there isn't much news in Orange Grove, but it's been ages. Not literally, but you know. They are never gonna find them. I wish everyone would just stop. Leave us alone, so I can forget that whole god-awful night. Some think my dad was a hero for trying to stop them. Truth is, we never saw them coming. When that guy jumped and stabbed my dad, something snapped, and I would have punched him, scratched his eyes out. I swear, I think I could have killed him, but the other one got to me before I even knew there were two. I never saw their faces. Neither did my dad, so they never caught them. I'm not fearless. And there's that part of that newspaper clipping. Well, no wonder if Trevor had anything to do with it. Nothing was different. January 5th. We're all just matter. That's what Kelsey keeps saying, and she's right. But matter is also life, and life is something we need to take care of. She likes to be out on a limb. She says she's got nothing to lose. Bam. She didn't even realize what she was saying. Or maybe I'm too sensitive. Guess that'll show me to believe that we were friends. I guess I'm a shadow person after all. Shadow person. I think she's gonna break her neck, by the way. See if I care. Loving the chemistry. Life matters. January 19th, 2018. Happy birthday, Mom. January 28th. I'm trying to ignore the fact that all of Kelsey's cute stuff is paid for with Trevor's money. He is such a creep. I don't get what she sees in him. She says I'm jealous. As if. Thing is, she needs him to get away from all this. But she doesn't. She got away from her mom all on her own. Kelsey's the smartest, coolest, sweetest person you can imagine. She doesn't need anyone to get her out. She can do that all on her own. Too bad she doesn't believe that herself yet. Beep boop. February 14th. Bleep. I'm so stupid. I finally got to see La La Land. They showed it on Classics Night at the theater. I went with Ben. Loved it. Kelsey was there, too. I was so happy to see her. Actually friggin' hugged her. And she pushed me away. Asked me what I thought I was doing. And that Trevor asshole was enjoying the show. And her stupid cheerleader friends. So she liked La La Land. Kelsey did not. February 14th. Still? I feel out of place. Everywhere outside of this room. She said she was sorry. I know. But I feel like I'm walking on eggshells, and that's not what a friendship should be like, right? I feel disconnected. She did not want to be my friend. She was embarrassed. Bleep, bleep, bleep. Don't ever forget. Oh, that's the stones through the window. February 16th. Okay, I've calmed down a bit. That Lala night she was with Trevor. And he is such an asshole. She's different when she's around him. Not that it makes it alright. But she did come straight over to tell me she was sorry. She knows she was wrong. Broke my window with that damn rock. She said if I had answered the call of the pebbles, she wouldn't have thrown the rock. She's been there ever since. Doesn't have anywhere else to go, really. Except for Trevor. I'm glad she'd rather sleep here. Right now, as I write this, she's on the bed going over some notes from class. I like having her here, and Dad's okay with it. Alright, so she did just start staying there. March 17th. Oh, those sparkly shoes. She wears them all the time. Last night the heels dug into my calf. That freaking hurt. Have you seen those heels? So I yanked them off her feet, and I told her not in the bed. She was amused. I can't think why. To be honest, I wish I was a size 9 because they look absolutely gorgeous. On Kelsey's feet, at least. When I tried them on, I looked like a little girl trying on mommy's shoes. March 17th. You may have noticed, sweet journal, that there are less and less F-words in these pages. I am so frickin' proud! Ha! It's the other F-word, though. Only when I go berserk, like when Kelsey threw that rock through my window, that it's hard to keep up. Did you know that as a little girl I used to curse abundantly? Trying to extend my vocabulary here. Dad thought it indicated intelligence, and I guess it looked cute up to a certain age, but he said Mom hated it, so every time I used the F-word, he made me put a piece of candy in the swear jar. Can't tell you how much that hurt, every time, because I'd never see it again. I think he secretly ate it. He must have rejoiced, yup, vocabulary extension again, every time I swore like a madman. Madwoman. Must have. The effing swear jar. She called me her friend today. I am not a shadow person anymore. She's my friend. March 27th. I have a dream. April 9th. Kelsey is so angry at the world. Like, all the time. It's kind of annoying, but I get it. We all have a different story to tell. So as a friend, I did the only decent thing. I told her she can do anything she wanted. She just had to make it happen. Not wait for it. I told her to deal again. The cards. Okay, so not drugs, okay. Clearing that up. All is now harmed. April 11th. Kelsey broke up with Trevor. Finally. She can do so much better than that total loser. He assaulted her in the school hallway. Of course, no one saw it happen, but he literally tore the clothes from her body. F... space, space, space. And I promise not to swear, so there you go. But she's done with him now. Things can only get better. April 13th. I think he's crazy. He keeps calling me at the most impossible hours just to yell at me. Calling me names, threatening that if I don't let Kelsey go, he'll do this or that. As if I've got her tied up in here. I now unplug the phone when I go to sleep. Alright, so Kelsey doesn't know all this stuff. May 22nd. These are the good times that make me forget. All my troubles seem so far away. All my troubles seem so far away. Wait a minute, is that a song? May 19th. May 19th. Oh, so this is before that. Kelsey took me night swimming in Mr. Jones' pool. I was scared shitless the first time, but ah, two beers and freshly picked oranges. Chill. Best nights ever. June 7th. Took me forever to convince Kelsey to ride a bike because it ain't cool. Our rides are the best part of the day now, and on this day we rode them through Mr. Jones's orange grove. In broad daylight, we got home with a basket full of the juiciest golden oranges. I didn't even think about getting caught. Nothing was the same. Oh, I need to fill in something here. June 30th. There's been another invasion. Just two blocks from here. They killed the woman this time, and the police think it's Trevor. Suppose it was him in our house? I can't wrap my head around it. It's too big. But Kelsey says it's true, that Trevor is a bastard, but would never convince... Oh, but Kelsey says it isn't true, sorry, that Trevor is a bastard, but will never commit such violent acts. Looking at that torn t-shirt, I think she might be in denial there. July 5th, I did it. I hope I'm not going to regret this. July 7th, we needed this. Beer, water, and oranges. Like so many nights before Trevor. No, I am not going to let him spoil my night at the pool with Kelsey. He who shall not be named shall not be named. Not today. Okay, so maybe we get on the computer to get this stuff. And yes, there's also some missing pieces here. Maybe something here. Maybe something here. Can I skip ahead like this? No. So what do we think about that? I'm not a shadow person. Shadow?
Damn, what's the password again? I need to find it.
PS1. Kitty GIF. GIF! And it's GIF! Damn you. Torres Wi-Fi, internet access. 33% charged. I want to see the GIF. Okay. Well, you have a very empty desktop, Marie.
One day, I just had to know. What's up with all the cats? She said she admired them. That they were who they were without any pretense. That they had no fear of confrontation. She wanted to be more like them.
Sure, cats fear some things. My pet is missing.
When Bumblebee went missing, Marie cried for days. She thought I couldn't hear her at night. I could never prove it, but I'm sure it was Trevor.
Jeez. Trevor guy's been busy. Missing since June 23rd, 2018. Okay, so we need to find that. That's after they went to the pool. Bumblebee, 4-year-old cat. Category cats. Gender male. Breed orange and white tabby. Bumblebee usually wears a red collar with his name. He's an orange tabby with white chest and paws. Green eyes. Please help me find him. G&K Web Store.
Marie, what were you thinking?
Oh my.
You know that's illegal.
Okay. Even that looks like a cat or paw print or something. So I can't click on anything. Mail. Mail time.
Why does someone need to get hurt before we step up and act, for Christ's sake? If they had, none of this shit would have happened, and no one would have died.
June 12th. From Mr. Phillips to Marie Torres. Gmail. Hi, Marie. It grieves me to hear that this is how you feel, but I'm afraid there's not much I can do at this stage. I understand you are alarmed and feel unsafe, but Trevor has not broken any school laws, nor has he hurt anyone. I would like to invite you and Trevor into my office to see if we can start up a conversation between the two of you. Let me know when you are ready to talk. You know where to find me. Kind regards, Principal Phillips J. Trevor. Oh,
no.
Oh, boy.
Why didn't you tell me? Marie, no wonder you were so frightened. We never should have gone to the Orange Grove.
Right, now. Gonna say maybe. Because it says five, though. There's five messages. Harassment by fellow students. I guess this is part of the harassment. Trevor. Can I. There's nothing else. All right. Just messing around. All right, back to the journal. Okay, still don't have that. I love cats because they're not afraid to be difficult. Today was a good day. May 19th. Only five emails from Trevor. Only five. I hope he's finally getting it. Oh my god. She's not coming back. He really holds me responsible for it. I can handle that if he keeps him away from her. When I saw him in the hallway this morning, he slid his finger across his throat again. If he wasn't such a scary-ass clown, I'd laugh. But he does scare me. I don't tell Kelsey these things. She shouldn't worry. The cat, though. When did the cat go missing? June 12th. They're not listening. Oh, that's where it is. I've tried every authority at school. I even tried the cops, but they just patted my shoulder. Poor little girl, still traumatized. Bump on the head didn't do her any good. Beep. Yes, I'm swearing now. A jar full of candy. What should I do? I wish I could tell Kelsey, but she'd go insane and get herself hurt. Or worse, go back to him. Trevor is dangerous. That'd be horrible. June 23rd. I know it's him, and there's nothing I can do. They never believe me. And I don't think I'll ever see Bumblebee again. June 30th. I can't sit and watch. I'll have to be fearless. I found this site where you can buy guns off anyone. Not that I mean to shoot anyone, it's just... I don't know what to do anymore. It's for protection, you know? Isn't that what they say? Anyway, there was this guy who wanted to sell me this totally new 9mm. I'm meeting him out of town somewhere. A little shady, I admit, but with Trevor looking around, I'll take my chances. Let me guess, the guy selling the gun is Trevor. I like how it shoots flowers in that, though. Oh, wait. I saw something flash there, like I thought I could go back to that. No? Right. So, what's this code? What's this 5-digit code? It's a 5-digit code, right?
I need to find the key. A 5-figure number.
Can I leave the room? Do something great. A 5-figure number.
Food rescue. Yeah, it was a good place. The Green Eatery. Green as in with.
Swimsuit. Would I see Flash by there for a second? Beer bottle.
Mr. Torres loved that beer. After the robbery, he only had a couple left. Apparently they were hard to come by. Still, we decided to try a bottle once. Marie loved that label. She drew it in her journal. I remember that. All that happened later that night, I'm not sure. Maybe I don't want to remember.
Okay, we've updated the journal. I didn't see that from the side. So let's see what we've got. We're looking for a drawing of a beer bottle. I'm not seeing it. Oh, this? This is it, right? It just says... Now, if it was a 4-digit, I would say that's a date, right? But we got 5 digits. What could be 5 digits? Do new things get uncovered here as well?
One day, I just... When... Bumblebee... Marie... What were you thinking? You know that... Why does someone need to get hurt? Oh no... Why didn't you tell me, Marie? No wonder you were so frightened. We never should have gone to the Orange Grove.
One, one, three. I'm looking for anything that has numbers. Could be like 5, 1, 9, 18, for example. So arbitrary, though.
Chemistry holds no surprises. Love that.
Haha, I didn't notice that. Okay, we've got 4 digits there. I want to get in that. I don't know what else to look at here.
She asked me why I was so angry all the time, and I told her because...
It's a dirty deal.
I'm not a shadow person. Yeah, it took me all I had to convince her she wasn't.
Alright guys, what's this? Could be part of a... Doesn't really fit as part of a phone number, does it? I don't know.
Disgusting, but cheap.
Oh, it says I'm sorry there. Was that there before? I didn't notice that. Wake up there? Oh, way up there.
That's Marie's birthday. That's weird. I get. Yes. The science project. Of all people, they chose to pair me with the girl from Food Rescue. Outrageous. But I got over it, and chose to work my ass off. I had to if I wanted to get that scholarship. I thought I was so lucky. An adoring boy.
Yeah, you weren't that lucky. I don't really know. This code.
There's no such thing as food waste. And don't I know it? The smell of garbage will be in my nose forever, and the taste of it in my mouth. I swore I would never be that hungry again. I didn't care what it took.
Okay, so we added something to the journal. First page. Okay, high school kid saves classmates from hunger. November 9th, 2017. After that school article, people kept asking me why I did it. As if I was some kind of hero. So stupid. And I keep telling them the same story. Aren't they sick of it yet? Maybe I should publish a book. My life story. So they'll stop bugging me. Crazy people. Here, for the last time. Last fall, I caught a kid stealing someone's lunch from a backpack. As he stuffed the sandwich in his mouth, our eyes locked. He panicked, dropped the food, and ran. I never realized some of my classmates are actually hungry, so I joined Food Rescue to help. There. The end. Everyone satisfied? Is the code in here? It does nothing would fit. I mean, if you put 11, 17, 17, that's 6 digits. Oh, didn't mean to do that. A birth date? Her birth date is written down in that other book, but I don't have the year. Happy birthday. Okay. 1/19/18. Oh, not 18. When was she born? When was she born? She died when she was 5 years old, but I don't know when. I don't know when Marie was born. Maybe this date. 2/14/18? Doubt it, but 2/14/18.
What is the code, Marie? Wait. The journal. It must be in the journal. She must have written it down here somewhere.
Is it gonna pop out now more than she knows? these numbers here. That's 1, 5, okay. 3, 4, 3, 4, 9, 5, 1. 3, 4, 9, 5, 1. Thank you for the hint. 3, 4, 9, 5, 1. I'm gonna get it anyway.
What is the code, Murray?
Shh.
Wait. The journal. It must be in the journal.
Shush, it'll go away. 3, 4, 9, 5, 1.
Yay! Good work, Kelsey.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Same reaction. She's got a gun.
The past, like the future, is indefinite and exists only as a spectrum of possibilities. Stephen Hawking said that. I wish it were true. But there was nothing I could do about the past. It was definite as hell. Sometimes I didn't get Marie. I really thought a night by Jones's pool would help her relax. She used to love it there. But she insisted someone had been watching us. I just wanted to have a good time, and she was ruining it. So I said some things I shouldn't have. She just stood there, staring at the window. I was so annoyed. And that's when I knew she'd been right. Trevor.
Yeah?
Right there in the room. He'd just come in through the open window.
Oh, God.
How did he find us? He didn't know where Marie and I lived. I always made sure of that. But he took an orange from his backpack and started peeling it.
All those peels.
It had been Trevor by the pool. And he'd followed us home. He said to Marie, I told you not to mess with me. But still, I didn't get it. No, it wasn't until he started moving in on her that I realized it was Marie. He was after Marie. He blamed her for everything, and he had a knife. I'd never seen him so angry, so evil. Marie tried to get it away from him. He asked her why she never answered her phone. Did she not read her emails?
Oh, jeez.
Did she think they were hollow threats? God, I just wanted to punch him with anything I could lay my hands on. My backpack. I smashed it against his wrist, knocking the knife out of his hands.
Go, Marie Kelsey.
Went for it, but Trevor was faster. He kicked her in the head. I dove for the knife, but he jumped me. As we struggled, he hissed, didn't I get enough action yet? Maybe I needed another baseball bat to get my kicks. I stopped, because right then I knew what he was up to. He asked Marie about Mr. Torres. Was he all right? Did he still get stomach aches?
It was him.
Marie lay on the floor by the bed, in shock, realizing it had been Trevor who almost killed her father. Then Trevor looked at me, added with a smile. And her. That's when it all went to pieces. Trevor ripped us apart, and he was enjoying it. Marie didn't understand. I tried to explain, apologized, but she wasn't listening. She kept asking me if I'd been there with Trevor. In their house.
She was the other
Trevor
one?
Trevor stirred things up even more. He told her it was me who had hit her over the head with a baseball bat, that I'd enjoyed it. I screamed in frustration. No, that's not what happened. Tears streamed down Marie's face. She couldn't believe I would do that, hurt her deliberately. God, I wanted Trevor to stop talking. I attacked him, scratched his face, hit him wherever I could. I hated him. He was twisting everything. I wanted to tell her that I was sorry. Yes, we robbed the house. And we got caught by Mr. Torres. But I never meant for anyone to get hurt. I didn't smash Marie's head. I panicked. I wanted to stop her from seeing me. When I realized how badly injured she was, I called the police. I tried to stay, but Trevor wouldn't let me. He pulled me by my hair into the van. But Marie wasn't listening. I was losing it, and I like to think I beat Trevor up pretty good. But Trevor punched back harder and faster. He was about to crack my skull. Marie clawed for the box beside her, opened it, She screamed, told us to stop, pointed that 9mm at us. Trevor went nuts, charged for her. She screamed, told him to stay back. She'd never shot a gun in her life. She wasn't going to start now. Trevor grabbed her by the shoulders and...
Oops.
What do you think you remember is not necessarily what really happened, or how others remember it. But Trevor fell back on the carpet, dead. That we all remember.
Then she left for Vancouver. And Kelsey followed. What if I go downstairs? I didn't try that. Can't go downstairs. All right. Alright, fine.
Mom, where are you? Did you get the journal?
I'll be down in a minute.
Aunt Marie is getting a little worked up here.
Aunt Marie.
Smoke a cigar. In your car.
Don't let her. Don't let her smoke. I love that car.
She knows you do. Get down here, Mom. You're taking, like, forever.
I'll be down in a minute.
Bring the journal.
Aunt Marie.
Of course I knew it was her. Who else? There was only one thing to do. Get to Marie.
Now I can press J for journal. Aw. I regret food rescue. I regret the science project. I regret it all. My father could have died because of me and my inability to pick real friends. Kelsey never was who she said she was. I never really knew her, it turned out. It's all bullshit, and I'm so stupid. I should have realized it that Lala night and walked away for good. Because someone died right in this room. I made him die. I pulled a trigger, made a bullet pierce his head, made his blood soak the carpet, drip through the cracks into the floor where it will remain forever, to bear witness to what I'm capable of. I can't stay here. Am I the same me? I don't know anymore. I have to fix this. Fix me. Away from her. I have to focus on the positives in my life and stop questioning myself. Why did she do it? Why did I do it? Did I deserve this? Am I an evil person? A killer? I shot him in the head, for Christ's sake. I could have gone for his leg. Dad calls them intrusive thoughts. I say they're the truth. I'm stronger than I look. I can do this. I will go up north to Uncle George, as Dad suggested. Nice and cool up there. I'll be able to think and finish high school. I'm leaving this journal here because I need a clean slate and fresh pages. Is that my phone making that sound? I'm sorry. Dear Diary, maybe I'll send for you someday when all of this is long over and I've dealt with being a murderer. Hi, Kelsey. Yes, I'm talking to you. I know you've been reading my journal. Can I ever forgive you for what you did? Honestly, I don't know. I'm trying really hard, but I don't know how, because I don't understand any of it. You were my friend, and I loved you unconditionally. I did what I did because of you. I stood up to him because of you. But you? I don't know. Right now, I can't be near you, so I don't want you to come find me. I promise I'll be all right. Marie. Trying to see if anything else has been filled in.
She wouldn't talk to me on the phone, so what else could I do? I drove all the way up there to Vancouver.
Guilt trip.
Freezing my ass off in that tin can of a car.
It was also Marie's guilt trip.
No, that's her parents' room. Don't need to go in there. That's the bathroom.
That's the car beeping outside. Well, what did you guys think? Yeah, I guess two episodes. Kelsey, played by Lauren Hindler. Sounds familiar. So thanks so much for watching. This is a good candidate to go in the Tiny LPs playlist. Thank you for letting me play. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. I found this pretty damn interesting. There's a lot of things explained, but some details left out. I'm sure you can fill in with your imagination, which is always good. So thanks again, and always, seek adventure.